Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I'm going to showcase the latest release by my favorite things. Now I have a box here and I'm going to do the unboxing, I'm going to show you all the products that I got and then I'm going to share 5 cards using many of the products so you can see them in action. Now this release is packed with wonderful products, it's one of those releases that it is really hard to choose a favorite. Today I'm mainly going to share examples using the dies and I will come back with another video using the stamp sets. And let's start with a Joy Wreath stamp set. This gives you the wreath along with lots of stamps for berries and the word joy that fits inside the wreath if you want to put it there. And as always there are matching dies available if you want to grab those as well. And this is actually one of the sets that I will be using on today's video for one of my cards. Now let's move on to 2 stamps which are absolutely adorable. These stamp sets are full of critters. The first one is called May Moments and the second one is called Reindeer Games. So the first one you see gives you both lots of bears as well as trees and other stuff that you can create little scenes, and of course they give you lots of sentiments to play with. Now the second one, which gives you 3 reindeers in different positions, also gives you lots of different elements to embellish your card. You get sentiments as well. Now for both of these sets there are separately sold matching dies that you can grab if you want to pop your images. On today's examples, I am going to work mainly with the dies from this release, but I will come back with another video where I will be creating many critter cards with lots of winter scenes. Now let's take a look at 2 more stamp sets, both of them with snowmen and reindeer. The first one, the larger one, is called Festive Friends. It gives you many snowmen and reindeer as well as lots of sentiments to play with. And the second one, which is slightly smaller, is called 'Tis the Season. It gives you Santas as well as snowmen and little trees and gifts that you can play to embellish your cards. And of course you can get matching dice if you want to. And now let's take a look at my favorite of this release. This is a huge stamp set. It is 6x8 and it is called Christmas Selfies. You get 6 different squares with lovely images inside. Some of them have snowmen or elves or polar bear or even Santa. You can stamp many of them or just one as a focal point on your card. If you love coloring, I'm sure you are going to absolutely love this stamp set. Now let's take a look at the sentiments for this month. This is the Peace on Earth sentiment. It is in a lovely script font and I love the size of it because it really makes a statement on a card. Now this is the Holiday Tag Dog. It does have sentiments as well as words which are perfect for a tag, for a gift tag, but of course you don't have to use them just for that. This is the We Wish You a Merry Christmas stamp set. It is a sentiment and at the same time it is a tree, so it creates a great focal point. I would create a beautiful inked background and emboss it on top. I think it would look great. Now here is a fun sentiment stamp set. This is called Sassy Pants Holiday 2. The sentiments in this stamp set are really hilarious. I'm going to read just one of those. Sorry your birthday is so close to the holidays, but I'm not buying you 2 presents. I think this is super fun, especially for my family, since my daughter has her birthday on the 17th of December and we joke about it all the time. This is the Bitty Holiday Wishes stamp set. If you need a sentiment stamp set that is packed with sentiments for this season, this is the one for you. I counted all the sentiments and they are 27 here. And of course you get Christmas sentiments like Merry Christmas and such, but you also get Happy New Year and Happy Hanukkah and season's greetings. So it is versatile and perfect for this season. And let's take a look at the dies for this month. This is the gift tag. It gives you not only the basic shape, but lots of little elements that you can cut out to embellish your gift tag. This is the classic snow globe and I will be using this one today. It gives you all the dies that you need to create a snow globe with a snowman inside. They have also released pouches that fit inside that snow globe. And since I love shaker cards, I absolutely adore this die set. This is the Peace on Earth die set. It gives you the bird, the branch, as well as the die cut sentiment. And I will show you an example using this one as well today. This is the Joy, Love and Peace die cut. It not only cuts out the words, but also little elements that you can embellish the words with. And I will be using this today so you can see how it works. It's a great die for mass producing cards. And here is another favorite and very unique die set. It is called Little Town of Bethlehem, and I will be using this one on one of the examples today. You will see it creates beautiful scenes. This is the Merry and Bright sentiment. It is perfect for beautiful backgrounds where you just want to stick on top a huge sentiment that really makes a statement. This is the Elfin Around die set, and you can create an elf's hat, super fun as a focal point on a card. And now they have released a whole collection that is called Christmas Crew, and I have two die sets from this collection to show you. The first one, the biggest one, is called Christmas Crew Boy Elf, and the second one is the Christmas Crew Reindeer. And you will find even more designs, such as an elf girl, there is a snowman and a Santa, I believe. These are meant to dress up the gift card pockets, but of course you can use them separately if you want on your cards. Now in my package I also got a couple of stencils. One is the snowfall horizontal and the other one is the peace, love and joy, perfect for lovely backgrounds. And I believe there are a few products that I haven't shown you yet that have been released as well, but they were not included in my package. Now I'm also going to show you the big rubber stamp. This one has ho 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 written all over it, and it is perfect to add something extra on your backgrounds. Now, this is quite big, so it is going to cover up completely a card front, no matter if you place it horizontally or vertically. So these were all the products. I'm going to put them aside and I'm going to share 5 cards using most of the dies from this release so you can see them in action. And for the first card, I'm going to use the Wreath Joy dies. I'm not going to use the stamp set for this card, just the dies. So I'm going to cut out the wreath out of green cardstock, the berries out of this glitter cardstock, and the word Joy out of gold cardstock. Now I'm working on Nina Craft cardstock, and this is a 4.25 by 5.5 panel. I am going all around it with my vintage photo distress oxide ink, and I'm going for a very traditional looking card and with a touch of vintage on it. So I have also cut out a little frame using the glitter red cardstock, as you can see on the right. And you can see here I moved on to a darker distress oxide ink just to darken up the edges a little bit more. And since I'm going for a vintage look, I'm also going to add a little bit of inking on my wreath. Now also I cut out 2 wreaths so that I can stick one on top of the other and make it look fuller, but it looks beautiful as it is on its own. Now this is where I'm doing some splashes on my background. This is white gesso diluted with water, and this is going to give the illusion of snow at the background. And to complete the look that I'm going for, I'm going to add some splashes all over the wreaths as well. I left everything to dry and now I'm ready to put my card together. With my Nouveau Deluxe glue, I'm adding a little bit at the back of this frame and I'm going to stick it on my panel. And I did the same for the wreaths, one on top of the other, and now I'm adding the little cutout berries on top of my wreath, spread it out with Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back. To finish off my card, I'm going to stick the word Joy at the center of my wreath. I absolutely love the outcome of this card, and I think that it's not that difficult to mass produce, especially if you work in a production line. So for example, do all the die cutting for the sentiment, then all the die cutting for the wreaths, and so on. And here are some close-up photos on this design. Now I know that most of us like to create multiples of Christmas cards so that we can send them out, and it is always nice to find designs that are not as time consuming. So one of those dies that are really great for this reason is this Joy, Love, Peace die. So you can place it on top of white panels, run it through your die cutting machine, and then all you have to do is to back it up with a beautiful cardstock. And if you want, you can embellish it with the little die cuts that come together with that die. So here I used a gold mirror cardstock, and then I'm going to embellish each of those words with something extra. Everything that you see cut out there, like the tree, is one of the dies, obviously, that I cut it out from green cardstock. I cut out the heart from red cardstock. And I'm also embellishing the tree one more time with the half of a tree, and that was again a die included. I am embellishing the letter O, and I'm going to put it in place. And as you can see, this is a super quick card to make. Again, all you have to do is to do the die cutting at first and then start putting cards together. And depending on the cardstock that you decide to put at the back, you will get different looks. For the next card, I'm going to use the Peace on Earth die set, which is another one of those die sets that is perfect for mass producing cards. And I'm going to show you a very simple design here. So I have this wonderful cardstock. This is by Nuvo, which I'm going to stick on top of my card base. And I made sure that it was narrower in width so that I end up having two strips of white showing at the edges. Now I'm putting together the elements. So I cut out the bird out of white cardstock and the branch out of green cardstock. And instead of using the whole piece on earth, I'm just going to use the word piece. But of course you can go ahead and use it as a whole. And remember that behind the bird you can use pattern paper or watercolor or inked up backgrounds. To finish off my card, I'm adding crystal gems, and this is going to turn out completely clear. You just see the white from the glue at the moment. And here are some close-up photos. Now for the next card, I'm going to use this Bethlehem die set, which is absolutely unique and I love it. I'm not going for a simple design. This is not a card to mass produce, but it is a beautiful card for someone special. This is probably one of my favorite dies from this release, and I'm going to cut out all those different scenes using craft cardstock. Now you can leave them as it is, simple, and put them in different heights to create your village. I decided to go in a more vintage looking card, so I am using my vintage photo and I'm going to ink up the edges. This is going to help all those die cuts to pop even more once placed one on top of the other. And notice that I'm not overdoing it, I'm not even dipping my blending tool into vintage photo, I'm just using what I have there. And you will see that it makes a huge difference once I place them again, one on top of the other. Now you can play around with them a little bit, decide which one is going first, second and third. And there is even one more layer that you can place at front, which is the actual ground, but I'm not using it for this card. So since I'm not using it, I need to cut out the bottom, since I don't want to have anything underneath that door. Now I'm going to place them again one more time, one on top of the other, and just try to eyeball where this door is going to fall so that I can darken up the back. Now if you want to take it a step further, you can back up the windows with some cardstock, and this is exactly what I'm going to do here. So I will use glitter cardstock at the back. Then you will be able to see the shine through those windows. I'm not going to do that for every window since they are so tiny and so many, but I'm going to do it for the easy parts. Now I'm going to work on my background, and I have a navy blue cardstock. I am using a tiny little dot, and you can find a dot from berries or for the centers of flowers. I'm sure you have one little dot in one of the stamp sets. I'm using gold ink to ink up the background. And hopefully I have a starry night here. Of course you can use gold paint and splatter, do some splashes. They are going to look gorgeous as well. So I have foam tape at the back of all those buildings, and I'm going to stick one on top of the other to create my village. And finally I'm going to stick it at the very bottom of my card base. Now this is where I decided that I wanted to darken up the edges, so I'm back to inking, and this time I'm using black soot only at the very top, and you will see that this is not going to block the shine on my stars. Now all I have to do is to stick the sentiment, which I have cut out from glitter cardstock. This glitter cardstock that I'm using today is all by Nuvo, and you will find links to everything down below, as well as everything else that I'm using. So as a sentiment, I went with Peace on Earth from the previous die set, and I'm using my glue at the back and stick it down. And of course I used the same cardstock to die cut the star, which I'm going to stick at the top. Finally, I'm using glue at the back of my blue panel, and I'm going to stick it on top of a glitter panel, which is the same glitter cardstock as the one that I used to die cut the sentiment. So I end up having a shiny border, and this is probably my favorite card for today. And I just can't say goodbye to you today without making a shaker card, so I'm going to use the classic snow globe die set for the last card, and I'm using here the window die to cut out my window. I'm going to turn the panel at the back and use my tape runner to add some glue, and then I'm going to put the pouch in place. Now, of course, you can go ahead and make a shaker card window with this snow globe without using the matching pouches, but it is really fun to use them since they are quite thick, and they give you lots of opportunities to add many different elements inside. Now, I'm going to use this light blue cardstock as the backing, and this is exactly where I'm going to create my little scene. I used glitter cardstock for the snow as well as the snowman, and now I'm going to stick down all the rest of the elements, like his hat, scarf, as well as the eyes and the buttons, and the nose, of course. Now, of course, you don't have to use the snowman from this die set inside the snow globe. You can use pretty much anything that fits inside, so you can create little scenes with your stamp sets. Now, inside I chose to go with diamond dust. This looks like sugar and it is perfect for snow globe cards. And I'm not going to use too much, just a couple of scoops are enough. Now I'm going to stick down the panel on top, and my little snow globe is pretty much ready. All I need to do is to stick down the base. For the base, I went with chocolate cardstock and used one of the dies from the kit. Now you can leave it as it is. I decided, however, to take it a step further, and I'm going to embellish the snow globe a little bit more. And for that, I'm going to use a couple of leaves from the wreath die, and I'm going to stick them down, creating a little cluster at the base of my snow globe. And of course, instead of using the leaves, you can always use some ribbon or thread and tie a little knot. And I'm going to finish it off with some glitter drops in a red color. Now, all I need to do is to add a sentiment. For that, I decided to combine a die and a stamp set. So this one is the Merry and Bright one, but I'm going to use only the word Merry, which I'm going to cut out from red glitter cardstock. I'm going to glue it in place, and then to complete my sentiment, I'm going to use the word Christmas from the stamp set, and this is the stamp set that I'm using. It's called Bitty Holiday Wishes, which is packed with sentiments, perfect for the holiday season. So I'm using the one that says Merry Christmas, but I'm only stamping the word Christmas, and that completes my card. Here are some close-up photos on my snow globe card, which is the last one for today. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired, and hopefully this video helped you out to decide which of these products are a must-have for you. Don't forget to like the video and leave me a comment down below. I hope you will all have a lovely day, and I'll see you all next time.